Good afternoon all. Sorry for the inconvenience for breaking this session. Now we are back and I think the audio should be clear now. So resuming our session, we have already spoken about things like couriers, fruits and vegetables. Now we go to about till when should we have to follow the precautions of COVID-19? That is a question which we were asked.
Right now, I can tell you for 6 months to 1 year, yes, you will have to follow for 6 months to 1 year.
Okay, so
lockdown end does not mean that, again I am telling you, it is not the end of the virus. Virus also looking for to get out, okay, to reach to other people after the lockdown. So mind well, this is the time that we will have increase in the number of cases if we don't take precautions. And in fact, in lockdown, the only precaution you were taking is to stay at home. But now, after lockdown, the responsibilities have increased. We will have to work also and we'll have to take precautions also. And do not take the virus back home.
So next question is, can we rejoin work now? We are normal office going people. Should we rejoin work?
Yes, the answer is yes, but with precautions. Take all precautions, and whenever you go out, first of all, do not wear a watch. Wear a mask. Take a bottle of hand sanitizer. Take either matchstick or a toothpick along with you. Preferably, do not use public transport. Still, whatever work you can do online, do it. And while you are back home, take precautions.
I am a transplant patient and I am on immunosuppression. So should I rejoin work?
Yes, not a problem. Again, if you are taking adequate precautions, you can rejoin. Obviously, it depends upon which profession you are. If you are directly exposed to lot many people, and if you think that the distance they come is, unfortunately, they will come within that 2 meters distance and speak to you, preferably use a face shield along with a triple layer mask or a simple homemade mask.
Then there is, what about pregnant women or those who are breastfeeding? Can they rejoin work?
As such, again, I can say they can rejoin their work, but obviously they will have to take precautions. And both precautions from pregnancy side also and precautions from coronavirus, the universal precautions, yes, they will have to take it.
Okay. I am a transplant patient. My last follow-up was 3 months back. Now I am due for my follow-up and my investigations. What should I do?
As such, the lockdown is over now. You should go and get your routine test done and meet your doctor. If your doctor is not within the state or within the city, then obviously preferably do an online consultation with him.
I don't have enough medicine to last.
Right now the courier service and the postal services are very much functioning. You can order to your concerned person. They will definitely be able to courier you through personal private couriers also and through the postal post office also.
I am on steroids and other immunosuppression. I am a kidney patient. Some of them might be transplant also. So can I reduce my immunosuppression, or in fact should I reduce my immunosuppression right now in this time?
No, you should not. You should continue whatever immunosuppression you are on, because reducing immunosuppression you are risking rejection, and treatment of rejection is again increased dose of steroids and blah blah things. Okay, so continue with whatever medications you are on. Do not worry. If you are taking precautions, nothing will happen to you. But obviously you should take one thing in mind, that you are on steroids, so your asymptomatic presentation will be more, the chances of you getting fever is less. So if you become breathless or if you develop cough which is not explained otherwise by anything else, do consult your doctor. Especially if you are breathless, do consult your doctors, because you may or may not get fever. Routinely, in any in general public, it is almost like 90% of the patients suffering from coronavirus, and those who become symptomatic have fever. But in transplant patients, fever will be only present in 50% of the patients.
So other thing is, I don't have a car of my own. How can I travel to my office?
You will have to use public transport. Yes, I say that if you have a private vehicle, then obviously you should use that. If it is not, then again, wear a mask, take a bottle of hand sanitizer with you, and the moment you touch any surface, suppose the handle of the bar of the bus, use it, but you hand sanitize it. Enter from the rear side of the bus, exit from the front side of the bus. While selecting a seat, make sure that you maintain social distancing, and in case your neighbor is having some respiratory symptoms, change the seat. And do not touch anything. But obviously, one thing is, you should keep in mind that virus will not go to your face and mouth unless and until you take it. So you are not supposed to touch anything. Any unnecessary things you do not touch. And if you think you have touched it, immediately use hand sanitizer.
Then can transplant be done in near future? In these coming times,
right now the government is not suggesting to go for transplants who are not life threatening. In the sense, kidney transplants, the government is not giving the permission right now. For liver transplant, the permission is yes, because in as far as kidney transplants is concerned, you can be on dialysis for a few months. Yes, you will have to bear with this. You will have to continue dialysis, and whenever appropriate time comes, because in transplants you will be subjected to some heavy immunosuppression at that time. So I don't want people to get infected with coronavirus. No, right now, till your doctor suggests that this is the right time, do not worry, continue your dialysis.
Which is a good sanitizer? Any company, anything which we should use?
Huh. Well, while selecting a hand sanitizer, obviously, everybody you should be knowing by this time that you should use 70% alcohol, isopropyl alcohol. But again, 3M company, you make sure that you buy a 3M branded hand sanitizer. And obviously, you will be confused when you go out, because on paper, everybody will be writing 70% alcohol. But you yourself test whether you are using the hand sanitizer of good quality or not. The steps to is that, first of all, whenever you apply a good quality hand sanitizer, it should become dry. Dry within 20 seconds, yes, it should become dry within 20 seconds. It should have a little bit pungent smell, and there should be a feeling of coolness in your hands when you apply it. If it is remaining wet for good number of seconds, even after 20 seconds have passed, that means your hand sanitizer is not good. And preferably, when you buy a hand sanitizer, ask for a bill, so that the cheating, because there are good number of brands available in the market with lab names, and you will not be able to know whether you are using it a proper hand sanitizer. And being one of the most important steps of to prevent corona, you should be buying or using a standard hand sanitizer.
My office has air conditioning, central air conditioning. Can the virus come through that central air conditioning?
First of all, if your office is a closed one, and if you are using a residential single unit AC, then the problem is not much. But obviously, you should keep your AC temperature 26 to 30 degree, one thing. Use exhaust fan, use ceiling fan, and preferably if you can keep a bucket of water within that cabin, so that the humidity does not fall less than 40%. And if you can open up a window, even while using AC, the basic funda of opening the window is to allow the air, outside air to come in, because in a residential AC, single home alone AC, it's within the air, the air which is present in the room only gets cooled. Recirculation is not there. And if you are in a centrally air conditioned big hall or something, then there are steps are different. You should check first of all whether the AC is being run 2 hours before your colleagues reach the office, and even after you have left, the AC should be on for another 2 hours. One thing, the exchanges should be minimum 12 per hour, and preferably continue your exhaust fan, continue your ceiling fan, and obviously the temperature should be between 26 to 30 degree centigrade temperature.
Okay. So basically both at work and at home, some precautions we'll have to take regarding the AC.
AC, yes.
It will be both, I think both the sites, it will be the same precautions. Other thing is, how can we differentiate a regular flu from COVID? If I have some mild fever, cough, cold, do I have COVID every time?
As said, basically the symptoms are similar. Cough, fever and sore throat, yes, it can happen in both flu as well as COVID. But loss of smell and taste is more or less specific to COVID. And obviously if you develop difficulty in breathing, but difficulty in breathing usually occurs 7 to 8 days after the onset of symptoms. So difficulty of breathing should not be taken as a distinguishing feature because it's too late. So loss of smell and loss of taste, if you have it, and obviously you should have an history of exposure to a person of COVID, then obviously you are a suspected case of COVID, you should get yourself tested and get treated accordingly.
I am an asthmatic patient, so with the weather change or some pollen exposure, I keep getting breathless. So does that mean I have COVID?
No, the answer is no. And you should continue, if you are on steroid inhalers, please continue that. Just because steroids are not supposed, you are not supposed to use steroids and everything, you do not stop your steroid inhalers, continue them. And obviously by this time you must be knowing, okay, what is the precipitating factor of if during this routine, if there is a change in the season and you get it and you are getting it, relax, it is just asthma and not COVID.
Okay, I met someone at my workplace who turned out to be COVID positive. I was working with that person 2 days back. What should I do?
Well, it depends first of all how many minutes you met with that person, what was the distance between you and that person when you met, how many minutes you spent, and whether both of you were wearing mask or not. If both of you were not wearing masks, and if you stayed with that person more than 15 minutes, and if you have come within a distance of less than 2 meters, yes, you are a contact. The chances of you getting is high. But obviously if both of you have at that time worn a mask, especially a triple layer mask, then obviously you getting a COVID-19 positive test is less. So it depends upon the time spent between you and the infected person, one thing, the distance between you and the infected person, second thing, the type of the mask and the mask you wear at that time. And obviously even after this, you should be watchful. If you think you have been exposed, better you go home, isolate yourself for 7 days, watch for symptoms. If there are symptoms, get the COVID test. If there are no symptoms after 7 days, and if you are just a contact with no symptoms after 7 days, probably you can be back to work. But obviously, without your doctor consultation, do not come back to work.
I have some symptoms after the contact in 7 days of quarantine. I had mild fever, maybe mild sore throat and cough. Whom should I contact? Where should I go?
Then rather than contact, you are now a suspected case if you have developed symptoms. So ideally, you should get yourself tested. do not rush to the lab. You will need a prescription from your doctor that you need a COVID-19 test and you need to fill up an ICMR form. Get these tests, both this done. These two forms will go to the government approval. If government approves them, then you will be tested. But by the time you get results, take it as if you are positive, quarantine yourself. Because if you have a contact with a person who was having COVID and you are developing COVID symptoms, that means you are suffering from COVID. You do home quarantine at least till the report comes positive or negative. If it is negative, well and good. If it is positive, continue your home quarantine, or it depends whether if you have any comorbid conditions, like if you are diabetic, hypertensive, having ischemic heart disease, CKD, or you are in immunosuppressive drugs, and if you develop difficulty in breathing, you are not a candidate for home quarantine. Straight away, call your doctor and get admitted yourself into a hospital, COVID hospital.
Can I keep a pulse oximeter at home and keep looking at my saturation to know early signs of deterioration for myself in home quarantine?
The answer is no, because if a pulse oximeter, if it shows that you are having a declining in oxygen, it is too late. So not to rely on pulse oximeter, rely on the symptoms. If you develop difficulty in breathing, do not remain in home quarantine. Do not wait for the symptoms to disappear. No. Straight away call your doctor and shift from home quarantine to hospital if you develop difficulty in breathing. So pulse oximeter will not help you, because by the time pulse oximeter shows that you are having decrease in oxygen saturation, it's going to be too late. So not to rely on pulse oximeter.
I have Arogya Setu app, and I just went through that, and it is showing me that there is a moderate risk of infection for me. How will I know that whom did I come in contact to make it moderate risk, and should I get immediately test done?
Well, obviously, if Arogya Setu is telling you are at a moderate risk, but I don't think so that Arogya Setu application will help you to finding out the contact. No. That you yourself has to decide that in last 14 days, where did I go and which place I had gone, which was the person who got infected. You yourself have to be vigilant in that. The Arogya Setu will just tell you that you are exposed, you are having a person who is right next to your neighbor, there is a patient of COVID. Yes, that will tell you. But obviously, whether you are exposed or not, whether you have come in contact with such a person or not, Arogya Setu is not going to tell you. It is a good app. Yes, it's a good app to tell you that, okay, the coronavirus has come into your society. Yes, it has come into your society. So you have to take more precautions. You have to supposed to avoid touching all the things. Do not use a lift at that time. If you have to use a lift, press the button with a toothpick or with a matchstick. Yes, these are the methods. When you use a lift, face the wall of the lift. Avoid social distancing, avoid touching unnecessary things. Yes, do all these things.
Few questions which we had left probably earlier and getting them in now. So how do we sanitize our chappals and sandals when we're walking from outside and coming? It's very common for people to spit even now in India, and we wear chappals and come inside our house.
First of all, if you ask me, spitting should be made a punishable offense. Obviously, I cannot do this, but what I can do is I can tell you how to sanitize your chappals and shoes. Obviously, it depends whether they are washable ones or not washable ones. If they are washable ones, just detergent and water is good enough to sanitize them. If they are not washable ones, use 70% alcohol with a cloth, you dampen with the alcohol and you clean it. That is sufficient. But obviously, make a habit that you will not enter your house with shoes on or with slippers on. Differentiate. Whatever you are wearing in house, do not take it outside, and whatever you are wearing outside, do not enter that thing with that chappals.
So for us, I think in Gujarat it has been norm always to leave our slippers outside and then enter. But however, people who are abroad or living in colder areas, they should remember these points very well, that when they enter, they should leave their outside chappals and whatever slippers thing, and then only enter.
One thing I should tell you, the traditional methods of living, actually basically it's coronavirus has given us one thing, they've reminded us that Indian traditional ways of living and eating are the best. If you follow your traditional rules, okay, say namaste to all, do not handshake, do not hug, that is good because namaste was there previously in our norms, it should remain. We never enter with our in the house with chappals, no, we do not. We do not enter the chappals into our kitchen, we do not do it. We always use our right hand to eat and use the left hand to serve. That is very, very important. We never talk while we eating. These are all the things which we, you know it, but we usually don't follow it. But if you overall analyze, you must have heard the word new normal. But actually, the new normal is, if you think wisely, it is just the old normal. Eat homemade food. Yes, eat homemade food. Be with the family. Do not take too much of stress. Spend time with the family. Be in touch with others. These are all the methods which you used to follow. There was a clear-cut sleep hygiene pattern in the older days. We used to sleep by 10, get up at 6 o'clock. Nowadays, because of the media and everything, probably our kids, they sleep at 2 o'clock and get up at 10 o'clock. Maybe the number of hours are same, but still, the quality of the sleep matters. Between 10 to 6 is different and between 2 to 10, it is different.
Okay, so in these times, is there anything which we can do to boost our basic immunity? It is a broad question, but I would like you to cover as many points as you can. And if there are foods, if there is exercise, anything.
First of all, it's a myth. One thing, just eating will not increase your immunity. No, you'll have to do lot many things to increase your immunity. First of all, again, sleep hygiene. Yes, very much essential. Stay positive. Stay touch with others. Yes, it decreases your stress level and obviously it increases your immunity. Then eat a balanced diet. Keep yourself hydrated. And most important thing is avoid COVID media. Because you do not know what things, whatever you hear is correct or not. And fear is one thing which definitely reduces your immunity. So, and most important, I forgot, exercise, meditate, do yoga. So collectively, it's just all these things you do it to increase your immunity. Do not rely on a particular food item to increase your immunity. No, it is all the efforts you do it. Yes, you will have a good immunity against everything. If you have good immunity, even if you get infected with the coronavirus, mostly it will be asymptomatic one. So, to boost your immunity, do all these things. Just do not rely on eating this food, that food.
Some people are requesting to have a session only in Hindi or Gujarati. I know that is not possible. So, we would try and include Hindi whenever possible in between.
Done.
But majorly, it would be between Hindi and English. I think that will have maximum outreach. Okay, the next question would be, okay, home quarantine. What should we do for home quarantine? Suppose I was exposed to a person, now I'm at home quarantine. So, steps to be taken, things to be done.
Okay, first of all, if you've already contacted your doctor and doctor has advised you home quarantine, that means you are either asymptomatic or having mild infection. And second thing, you already have a separate room in your house, which is a ventilated one, and obviously one family member of yours is ready to take care of you. That is very, very essential. Obviously, you will have to plan. Plan in selecting the room. One thing, it should be a ventilated one. It can have an AC and we can keep the AC on in the manner which I explained to you. Second thing, only an assigned person should come into that room. Reminding you, it's home quarantine, but actually it is a room quarantine. You are not supposed to roam about in the whole house. No, you are not supposed to do that. And second thing, it should be strict isolation. It is not that okay at the night time you are isolated and the daytime you are meeting all the members of the family? No. Strict hygiene. Second thing, monitor your symptoms. Check, do temperature check twice in a day. Grade your symptoms, your cough, fever, your difficulty in breathing, or any other symptoms. Grade them from 1 to 10. If the grades are getting better, that means you are improving. If you are clinically improving, that means obviously the virus is going out of your body. But reminding you again, if you have difficulty in breathing, persistent chest pain, if you have some kind of a mental confusion, or obviously bluish discoloration of lips and face is a late presentation, don't wait for that. The only thing is, all these three things, if they are there, chest pain, difficulty in breathing and mental confusion, call your doctor and shift to hospital care. In home quarantine, obviously you will have to make a list of things which you will clean. Who will clean? If the patient himself cleans his room, well and good. If he cleans his bathroom, nothing like it, because ideally the other person should not be exposed to this. But in case if the person is not willing to do it and the other person has to do it, make sure that other person enters the room, quarantined room, only after the windows are open. One thing, let 30 minutes pass off with open windows, and then only the other person should come. The same is with the bathroom also. Ideally, again, the sick person should do it herself or himself. If it is not possible, open the exhaust fan. Let 30 minutes pass off, and then only the person who is supposed to clean the bathroom should enter. There are a lot many things about home quarantine. I'll not be able to cover up entirely, because I have a presentation of 50 slides for home quarantine. So I'll not be able to cover up everything in that, but obviously I'll just say the indications and outline I have spoken. But if you want it, we can discuss home quarantine exclusively for 1 hour.
Yes, so hand wash with water and soap, and sanitizer. Which is the best way?
I think the middle one, hand wash with soap and water, is the best, because one thing is, it's readily available. It is not going to harm your skin, because too much exposure of alcohol to your skin will definitely make your skin having some problem. So better is effectively wise also. If you see, then also soap and water is better. But obviously, spend 20 seconds. And if you are infected, spend 40 seconds for hand wash. Any soap is good, any soap is good. Again, while use hand sanitizer, if they are wet, if they are soiled, hand sanitizer won't be effective. And obviously, a good quality hand sanitizer is must. You should understand this. Obviously, the difference in price will be there, but I'll suggest you use 3M hand sanitizer only. Overall, if you see the quantity of hand sanitizer, good quality hand sanitizer required is less as compared to a substandard hand sanitizer.
I have already become allergic to sanitizer. What to do?
Use soap and water. That's the answer. Actually, I'm always suggested soap and water is better than hand sanitizer. But obviously, going out, you should be carrying a small bottle of hand sanitizer with you.
Okay, then simple question. I want you, sir, to tell everyone the correct way of wearing mask. I know this session cannot cover everything, but some 3 or 4 points which everyone should remember. Maybe like they should cover their nose and wear it tightly.
First of all, select which quality of mask, whether it's a homemade mask, triple surgical mask, or N95 mask you are using. N95 mask should be used only by doctors. I still believe this is, I am very much clear about that, very much clear about this. Yes, a homemade mask ideally with the string should be used, one thing, so that you can fit it properly. Cover your nose and mouth both, and the moment it gets damp, humid or wet, remove it, change it. A triple layer, if you are using triple layer mask, after 8 hours you dispose it off immediately. do not keep that mask. While wearing a mask, do not touch the front side of the mask. If by chance you are a health worker and if you are using N95 mask, remove your beard if you have it. Check here the size, because if you allow air to enter from the sides of on the around the nose, it's of no use wearing an N95 mask. You should be proper check is there for N95 mask, that after you wear an N95 mask, you blow to see whether any leakage of air is there in the sides or not. If you have it, adjust it. If it is from the around the nose, you just press it around the nose so that it gets fitted. And if it is from the sides, adjust your straps.
So I think for general public, one thing that cover your nose and mouth.
Very important to cover your nose and mouth, because one thing we should keep in mind that sneezing is more dangerous than coughing. The number of particles or viruses coming out of sneezing is more than as compared to coughing.
And then the mask should be always tight. So as tight as you can, you should be able to breathe. Not suffocate.
That is the reason I am telling you, okay, rather than using the plastic strands, it is always better to have strings. So that you can tighten it according to your requirement.
And thirdly, never touch the surface of
the mask.
That is the worst you can do to your mask and for yourself.
And at times, if you are in such a situation that you have a habit of touching your N95 mask, it's better that you have a simple homemade mask above your N95 mask, just to protect your N95 mask. It is not that there will be an additional protection. No, N95 does not require any additional protection, provided it is properly fitted. Just that front surface of that mask doesn't get contaminated with virus or any other thing, you can use a homemade mask in front of that.
Okay, there is a question on Facebook Live which says, if a pregnant woman is infected with COVID-19, will the baby be infected too?
No, the baby will not be infected with this. But because it doesn't cross the placenta, one thing. Second thing, obviously, post delivery, she cannot breastfeed her baby directly. The express milk she can give it, because if she feeds the baby directly, then obviously she is too close, the baby is too close to her mouth. So breastfeeding is, there is no excretion of the virus through the breast milk, no. But it is just the contact with the baby and the mother that express milk should be used.
So basically we have not got any data till now to find any virus in the placenta or in the newborn baby or in the amniotic fluid or anywhere. So far no transmission is known through the placenta. And secondly, breastfeeding, please do not stop.
Take
precautions. If you cannot express it, would still suggest to wear mask. Take precautions, but do not stop breastfeeding. Ideally express it and give it to the baby. Yes.
You're very right.
Can I take some prophylactic medication for, suppose I was in home quarantine or I was exposed, even if I am not exposed, can I take some prophylactic medication?
Prophylaxis, I'll tell you, is for healthcare workers only, to be taken under supervision. After exposure, the prophylactic medication is not effective. And obviously, do not take it without consulting your physician, your cardiologist also. And obviously, if you are a transplant patient, you are not supposed to take hydroxychloroquine as prophylaxis, because hydroxychloroquine is known to prolong the QT interval, and your drugs like your tacrolimus and cyclosporine prolongs your QT interval. So even if you are a healthcare worker, ideally is to take a baseline ECG. First of all, anybody taking HCQ prophylaxis should be taking a baseline ECG. Give the loading dose of 400 milligram twice in a day, and after 24 hours of this, get a repeat ECG done. If there is no QT prolongation, it should be taken. For healthcare professionals, please take it. For general public, it is not required, because you are not exposed to the quantum and the of exposure which a healthcare professional is there. So, and again, there are drug interactions, so it is better that general public do not start HCQ prophylaxis of their own.
Is vitamin D helpful in boosting immunity?
Well, obviously vitamin D as such there is a role for vitamin D in the immunity thing, yes, but any, believe me, actually there is no immunity against the virus, because human beings for the first time is they are being infected with this virus. So direct immunity against the virus is not going to be there for anybody, whatever you do. It's only the overall immunity for vitamin D. For overall immunity, you should be having good vitamin D levels.
So we have heard that some countries have come very close to launching the vaccine. Is it true?
Well, whatever I have, or I have also read from the media, that there is a Moderna vaccine, okay, and then the brand name, which is, there is a RNA-1723 vaccine has been developed, and they have said that the percentage of effectivity is same as that of COVID infection. That means we are not expecting it to be 100% effective. Right now, after COVID infection, only 30% of patients are expected to have neutralizing antibodies, and same is the result with the current vaccination. The only thing is, only good thing is, it's a dose dependent response which is there. More the dose, more is the percentage of antibodies, and only right now only 42 patients have been tested on this. So obviously we need time, but again, vaccination does not mean that you can get away with the precautions. No, because the effectivity of the vaccine is never going to be more than 50%, and there are no methods till date whether to know that whether you have neutralizing antibodies in your body even after the infection. There are no tests available right now. Tests are there, but we do not have the kits right now.
Actually, we are getting some questions about individually about radical nephrectomy done 1 year back, what precautions to take, or somebody was on immunosuppression. But I would like to suggest all of you to go to the beginning of this presentation and just see it, because we have already covered what precautions kidney patient, transplant patient, or those who are on immunosuppression, they should take. So the precautions are same for all these high risk groups, which includes the transplant, whether you have undergone some surgery, whether like a nephrectomy, or you are a dialysis patient, CKD patient, or any other kidney disease for that matter.
I'll say something about that, that all the precautions are compulsory for all of you. One thing, the only difference is at times testing, just like in a case of home quarantine or even hospital stay, you are not required to test again. For a general public, it is not required to test again your COVID-19, but in case of immunosuppressed patients on dialysis, on transplant, it is must to document that you are free from coronavirus, because immunosuppressed patients and patients on immunosuppression, they tend to carry the virus, they tend to be the carriers of the virus for a long time. So it is the difference which your doctor will know it. But you as a person has to take the universal precautions of hand hygiene, respiratory etiquette, and avoid touching your face and mouth is very, very important.
Okay, some countries even claim that they have discovered medication to treat coronavirus.
Well, I will not say that there are good number of, this virus is for the first time has infected humans. We do not know is the history of this virus, and at present there is no definitive treatment till date. And obviously when 95% of the patients are going to recover from this, whether you give medications or do not give medications, medications are only for those persons who are having complicated infection. And I will not suggest right now, okay, you, this medicine is working or that medicine is working. And you should, as a person, you should be interested in how I should protect myself and the family, and not to worry about whether medication is available or vaccine is available or not. Just do your duty. Just listen to whatever I have said, or anybody whom you find is good enough to suggest you the proper way of dealing with the corona times. Yes, do not Do not search for anything which is easy. No. You have to take precautions right now. You have to take precautions. You will have to work. You will have to work. You will have to go out of your house. Yes, if required, you will have to go out of your house. But again, take precautions.
Okay. Again, I would just say that some questions which are covered, I'm not taking them up. But the new questions which we have not covered, we would be answering them. So there's a good one which says, if and when the vaccination will be launched, can transplant patient take that?
It depends upon, first of all, whether it will be a live vaccine or an killed vaccine. If it is a killed vaccine, you will be taking it. If it is a live vaccine, you will not be allowed by your physician.
So now I deal in public dealing. So we have a business over the counter where we talk to multiple people in a day. Should I wear a PPE kit?
No, you should wear a face shield with a mask. A PPE kit is very easy to say that I am wearing a PPE kit. It's very difficult to stay within that PPE kit. Doctors within the OT room also are finding it at times difficult to operate or continue with PPE kit. So PPE kit is not only for doctors within the COVID area. Yes, within the COVID area or a suspected case. Yes. PPE kit does not mean the proper hazmat suit. It means proper PPE kit means even a mask is a PPE kit. It's a personal protection equipment. So, but it differs for all people. Even for all doctors, it is not the same. Just like if I am in OPD, if I am wearing a triple layer mask and if I am wearing a face shield, it is good enough for me, provided I am not exposed to the patients who are having symptoms of cough, fever and breathlessness. But me being a transplant physician, the patients who are coming to me are immunosuppressed, they are on the drugs and they can be carriers of the infection. I will use an N95 mask. Yes, I will use it.
Should I wear a cap? Should I shave my beard when I'm...
Ideally, yes. Better to shave off your beard right now, because if N95 mask is not working, obviously a simple triple layer mask and a homemade mask is not effective. So it is better to get rid of this. Again, masks, it's better to shave off like me.
Cap.
But obviously everybody cannot do it.
Should we wear a cap when we are going to work, or maybe when we are in public dealing in a business?
I don't think so. That wearing a cap is required right now in public? No, I don't think so.
I wanted to go for a knee replacement surgery. It was an elective surgery, nothing emergency, but I am having a lot of pain now. Can I get it done now that the lockdown is coming to an end and hospitals have started working again?
Again, I'll say, if you can prolong it without surgery right now, just hold on. Because obviously, you will have to get a COVID test before entering into an OT, one thing. And the guidelines of getting COVID test are changing very frequently. I'll suggest hold on right now for it. But if it's an emergency surgery, if it's a life-threatening surgery, go ahead. But obviously, if a surgery which can be postponed little bit later, then well and good. And obviously, you will ask one question, okay, why are we taking precautions when you say that 50 to 60% or almost like 80% of the patients of the persons in India are going to get infected? Why to take precautions now? And why to allow, why you will be getting infected? The virulence of the organism is going to decrease as the epidemic is progressing. So you getting infected right now and you getting infected after 6 months, there is going to be a difference. Most of the persons infected after 6 months will have an asymptomatic presentation because the virulence of the organism would have been drastically low.
So basically, elective surgeries, if you can postpone them, semi-emergency and emergency should go on. You should not wait for them at home. You should be approaching the hospital.
Obviously,
and elective
if you are,
surgery will definitely
again, as far as knee replacement is concerned, if you are if you have to take an IM injections daily to get rid of that pain, and these painkillers affect your kidneys, it is better. Yes, again, it depends upon the emergency actually and
so
the requirement of it.
So you should discuss this
with your doctor, whether it is required or not.
The surgical aspect.
And obviously, the doctor will again take a decision upon your severity of the symptoms. In all non-emergency cases. In emergency cases, obviously, we will have to do surgery. We will be going ahead with the surgeries.
Yes. A few words about having children, especially who are infants at home, and old people above 60, how to take care of them. We are working couple, we go every day and come back home. There are grandparents and the children who are at home. How to take care?
I think this is a very important question, because the idea of lockdown was just to protect our elderly people. Again, these elderly people may get infected down the line. Yes, they will get infected, but by the time, again, as I said, the virulence of the organism will be very less and they will be coping up with the infection they have. So, if you are a healthcare professional, especially, do not meet your parents before you take a bath. Yes, do not meet your parents before that. You have to take care of your parents, very, very important. And again, same is with the kids also. Your kids may not have any symptomatic infection, but they can be the carriers of the virus. They can be the spreaders of the virus. And obviously, it is very difficult to make them follow the rules. It is very difficult for infants and kids to make them follow the rules. But it's right now, it is better that unnecessary, if you don't go outside, your kids will not go outside the house. And if you roam about unnecessarily, obviously your kids will follow you.
One important thing maybe you can mention, that if there is an infant or less than 2-year-old, if we are going out for some reason and have to take the child out, should we make them wear mask?
Well, I don't think so. Because when I wear a mask, if I get suffocated, I come to know it that I am getting suffocated. But if an infant wears a mask, he will not tell you that he is getting suffocated. So best is not to take the infant outside. If you take it by chance, do not use a mask.
So I think we are done with the time for now. We still have questions coming in, but I think we will make it 2.0 session where we will take next few questions.
And just like lockdown 1.0, 2.0 and 3.0, we will have this session also. And hopefully take simple precautions. Obviously, education is very, very important to get rid of the fear which we have of this coronavirus.
Thank you, Dr. Mumbai.
Namaste.